Hello everyone, welcome to Unlock Maths. Today we have to solve this example. Here we have given this function y, and from this one we have to find this two expression. Now here we can check that here we have in this first expression here we have y2 y1, right? That means we have to differentiate this y to get y1 and y2, so that we will get this first expression. First, here we have to write down what we have given. Here we have y is equals to e raised to a sine inverse x. Now we have to differentiate this y with respect to x, so that here we get first derivative, this y1, right? And now we have to differentiate, this is equation 1. This is of this form, this derivative of e raised to ax. And we know how to differentiate this is. We know that this derivative is here e raised to ax into derivative of ax. That means here we get this e raised to ax into a, right? In the same manner, here we have to differentiate this is. So here we have this e raised to a sine inverse x into derivative of a into sine inverse x. So e raised to a sine inverse x into derivative of this with respect to x, that means a is constant, and derivative of sine inverse x, this is 1 upon root of 1 minus x square. So we got this first derivative y1. Now we can shift this root of 1 minus x square on this side. So here we have y1 into root of 1 minus x square, and this is as it is. Now we can simplify this expression by putting this e raised to a sine inverse x as a y. So here we have this is as a y. So here we have y into a. So now we will call this is as a equation 2. Now in first expression we also want y2, that means we have to differentiate this equation 2 again with respect to x. Yes, here we have this two function of x, that means here we have to apply product rule. So we will call this as a first function and this is as a second function. Now we have to simplify this is y1, this is as it is, and derivative of root of 1 minus x square. Yes, we know that this derivative of root x, this is 1 upon 2 root x. So we have to write down this is here. So we have write down here 1 upon 2 into root of this into derivative of 1 minus x square, right? Yes, we have considered this is as a x for applying this formula. So we have to find out this derivative also, right? Yes, and this is plus into root of 1 minus x square into derivative of y1, this is y2, right? A constant, and derivative of y, this is y1. Yes, we have to simplify this is now, this is, and derivative of this is 1 derivative 0, and this minus, and x square derivative twice x plus this is as it is. Now this 2 and 2 get cancelled. So here we have minus x y1 upon root of 1 minus x square plus 1 minus x square into y2 is equals to ay1. Now we can multiply this expression by root of 1 minus x square. So here we have right. Now we can simplify this is, we can shift this term to this side. So here we have 1 minus x square into y2 minus this xy1 is equals to ay1 root of 1 minus x square, right? Now we get this expression. Now we have to check what we have to prove in first expression. Yes, we can check that here we got two terms, right? And from this one we have to write down this is. Now we can check that value of y1 into root of 1 minus x square. This is, we have already proved here, this is ay, right? So we have to write down this is as a ay. So here we have, this is by equation 2, right? Now we can simplify this. Now when we shift this, this get minus. So we have, this is required expression, right? So here we have find this first expression. Yes, this is here. Now we have to prove this second expression. In second expression, here we have yn plus 2, yn plus 1, yn, right? That means what we have to do here, we have to apply Leibniz rule for finding nth derivative of this expression, right? So first here we have to check down what is Leibniz rule. So here we have now here we know that derivative of u is getting decreased by 1 and derivative of v is getting increased by 1. And this nc0, nc1, nc2, these are the binomial coefficients, right? And we have seen this theorem in detail in last lecture. Now we have to apply Leibniz rule to this first expression, right? So first here we have to write down this first expression. This is again here. Now we know that when we apply Leibniz rule, we have to choose second function such that its successive differentiation get 0, right? So here we have to write down this is y2 as a first and 1 minus x square, this is as a second function. Right, same here, this is, we will write y1 as a first and second this x, and this a square y, this is as it is. So now by Leibniz theorem, this differentiating n times, so we have here this is y2 into 1 minus x square, its nth derivative, minus y1 x, its nth derivative, and a square y, its nth derivative. Now we have to apply Leibniz theorem first for this term. So here we have to write down this is y2, its nth derivative, then 1 minus x square as it is, plus nc1, then y2, its derivative is getting decreased by 1, right? And this derivative, this is first derivative now, right? Then plus nc2, then y2, next here again derivative is getting decreased by 1, that means here we have to write down n minus 2. This is here we have first derivative, and in next term here we want its second derivative, right? Then nc3, and next year derivative getting decreased by 1, that means y2 its nth minus 3 derivative, and 1 minus x square its third derivative, right? And now we know that third derivative of x square is 0, that means terms after this is get vanished, that means we will not get any term here. So here we have to write down 0, right? Next, this minus 4, this is here. And now we have to apply Leibniz theorem for this. So first function y1, it's nth derivative, right? X as it is, plus this is minus 4 is complete bracket, then plus, and c1 y1, its derivative is getting decreased by 1, and x is first derivative, and we know first derivative of x is 1, and after that when we take its second derivative, term get vanished. So here we have to write down 0, right? And this minus a square yn, a is, a square is constant, and y its nth derivative, this is yn, and this is equals to 0. And here now we have to simplify this expression. So we know that when we apply nth derivative on this y2, that means this get add, right? So here we have to write down yn plus 2. So now we have to do the simplification of this here. So here we have yn plus 2 derivative, 1 minus x square, this is as it is, and c1, this is n, and now this get add. So here yn plus 1, this is how to add here. Yes, this is y2 plus n minus 1. So this is yn plus 1. Okay, now 1 minus x square, its first derivative, 1 derivative 0, and minus as it is x square, its first derivative, this is twice x, then nc2, this is n into n minus 1 upon factorial 2, then y2 plus n minus 2, that means this 2 and 2 get cancelled, so here we have yn, right? And 1 minus x square, its second derivative, that means its first derivative. So here we have this minus 2. And next here, 1 minus x square, its third derivative. And this is 0. That means its first derivative. So first derivative is 0, right? Then minus, now again we have to simplify this bracket. So here we have yn plus 1 into x plus nc1, this is n, and now this is yn, right? X1, its first derivative, so this is 1, right? And next term is 0, minus a square yn equals to 0. Yes, what we have write down here, this is when we have y1, we have apply n minus 1 derivative, that means y1 plus n minus 1, this is minus 1 plus 1 get cancelled, so here we have yn. Now we have to simplify. Next here, factorial 2 is 2, so this 2 and this 2 get cancelled, right? And now what is simplification here, we have to check that 1 minus x square into yn plus 2. This minus we will write down on this front side. So here we have minus twice n x, right? Then yn plus 1. This 2 and this 2 we have cancelled. So here we have this minus on this front side. And then n square minus n. This is yn. And now we have to take this minus inside this bracket. So here we have x into yn plus 1. Again, this minus inside this bracket. So here we have n yn, and this a square yn as it is, right? Now we have to collect similar terms. Now we can check that this is here we have yn plus 1 term, yn plus 1 term, right? And here we have this yn, 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 right? This yn, yes, we will mark this is differently here. So we have to write down this term closer to each other. Next, 1 minus x square yn plus 2, this is as it is. Now here we have minus, both term minus, and here we have yn plus 1, yn plus 1 common, right? Again, we can check that here we have x common. So, remaining is here twice n plus 1 and common term is here x into yn plus 1. Now, all terms are minus here, right? And we can take this yn outside. So, here we have n square minus n. When we take this minus outside, so this minus get plus, this minus get plus, so here we have plus a square yn, right? Yes. Next, again we have to simplify. So here we have 1 minus x square yn plus 2, this is as it is. This is twice n plus 1 x yn plus 1 minus, now we can check that here. This minus n and plus n get cancelled. So, remaining is here n square plus a square yn is equals to 0. Right? And we have to check what we want in second expression. Yes. 1 minus y square yn plus 2 twice n plus 1 x yn. Yes. So, we got, this is the required expression. Right? This is expression number 2 we have proved here. So, in this way, we have to proceed for finding such expressions by using Leibniz theorem. So, we have to remember that when we have given such function, we have to check what we have to prove here. So, by differentiating first and second times, we get this first expression. And from this first expression, by applying Leibniz theorem, we will get this second expression. So that's it for now. See you in the next video. Thank you. Keep watching.